Hello friends, welcome to Vidya's Cooking. In today's video recipe, I'm going to show you how I prepared street style chicken momos. These turned out exactly like street food style. It was very tasty, very nice and juicy. Excellent recipe. All the ingredients are laid out for this recipe. All the ingredients list will be listed in the description box below this video. Here I'm using boneless chicken. This is cut into cubes. I'll be grinding it. You can also use minced chicken, ready-made from the store. I've peeled and reserved ginger, garlic, peeled and roughly chopped and reserved carrot, chilies, spring onion bulbs and the onion, half an onion, coriander leaves, spring onions, and cabbage. This is for the filling. For the masalas, I'll be adding some curry powder, garam masala powder, MSG, and soya sauce. You would also require 3 tablespoons of sesame oil. All the ingredients list will be listed in the description box below this video. This recipe in detail will be posted on my blog. Blog link will be in the iCard above this video. For the dough, I'll be using maida. That is 1 cup of maida, salt as per taste, and baking powder. Very simple recipe to prepare. I'm going to grind all these ingredients. So the carrot, ginger, garlic goes inside a small coffee blender. I've pulsed it twice to make it into a powdery format, and I'm going to transfer it into a mixing bowl. Don't even bother to chop all your veggies. You can grind it or pulse it twice and make it into a powdery format. That is what we want. Now I'll start grinding the cabbage in 2 batches. Exactly the same way. I'm going to pulse it twice and place it on 1 speed. And I've ground the cabbage into powdery format. I've reserved the cabbage. This is very simple recipe, friends. You cannot goof up with this. Here I've added the coriander, spring onion, and the onion. Again, I'm going to pulse this and grind it at 1 speed till it's into a powdery format, and I've transferred it. Now I'll grind the chicken. So everything is very simple set of ingredients that I've used. Whatever you have at home, you use it. Now the chicken is ground. I'm going to transfer it to a plate because the mixing bowl is very small. I'll mix all the ingredients using my hands itself. You can prepare this filling ahead of time and you can store it in the fridge. Even the dough, you can prepare the dough ahead of time and store it in the fridge. Now I've added the garam masala powder, the curry powder and soya sauce along with MSG. You can leave that MSG out if you don't want it. And I'm going to mix all these ingredients till it's well combined in the chicken. Marinated the chicken in soya sauce and masalas. I'll allow this to rest for a few minutes. I'll place a cover and allow it to rest for a few minutes. Now I'm going to start preparing the dough. I've added the maida, baking powder and salt. I've combined all these 3 ingredients first. I'll be using warm water and I'll knead this maida into a dough. So this is also a very simple dough that I'm preparing. Nothing too fancy. Now that you can see that the dough has formed, make sure it's not too tight dough. That's all I can tell you. Make sure it's a soft dough, because when you're preparing the momos, it should be a soft dough. Otherwise, your momos will be very hard. You cannot chew. It'll be rubbery. So at this point, the dough is ready. I've added 2 tablespoons of oil and I further kneaded it for a minute's time. I'm going to allow this to rest for 5 to 10 minutes. I'll place a cover and allow this to rest for 5 to 10 minutes. Now my chicken has been resting for about approximately 10 minutes since the dough is also resting. I'll be adding salt at this point because I'm going to prepare the momos. So add salt when you're going to prepare the momos. And I've heated up 3 tablespoons of sesame oil. I'll be adding the sesame oil. The sesame oil is a secret ingredient. It enhances the flavor and taste of this momos. So the filling is very nice and tasty. Now I'll combine all the ingredients once more so that the chicken is nicely marinated. It has got all that flavors of smoky sesame oil, salt and all of it. I've placed the steam basket for steaming. Now I'm using a Tupperware steam basket here to steam my momos. You can use a pressure cooker and idli stand to steam your momos, not a worry. I've placed the steam basket on a wok with water and it steams up very fast. So this is perfect to prepare momos. Now I'll be using a small lid to cut out the circles for my momos. And here you can see the dough has nicely rested. You can use a cookie cutter also. I'm using just a small lid to cut out the dough into circles. You can use a cookie cutter. Here you can see I've formed a roundel and sprinkling a little bit of flour, I'm just going to roll the dough into a roti, large roti. It should neither be too thick nor too thin. It's exactly how you're rolling out your pulkas. So that's the thickness we want. Now that I've rolled out the roti, I'm just going to start cutting the dough into circles. Here you can see I've cut out the circles. So once I've cut out the circles, I'll place the chicken filling and I've just folded it into half and pinched the edges and prepared the momo. A very simple folding is what I'm doing. Nothing too fancy here. So for beginners, this will be excellent. You don't have to do fancy foldings. Just fold it into half and that's it. Pinch the edges tightly. If it's not closing, then you can just wet the edges with little bit of water and pinch it. Now my steam basket is ready. I'm going to place the momos and steam cook this for 5 to 10 minutes on low to medium flame. The recipe in detail, friends, will be on my blog. Blog link will be listed in the description box below this video. Or you can click the icon above this video which will direct you to my blog. All the ingredients and measurements used in this recipe will be listed in the description box below this video. The same recipe is also posted in YouTube Tamil. YouTube Tamil link will also be in the description box below this video. For regular updates, do like me and follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. All my social media handle links will be in the description box below this video. So here you can see the momos is ready in 5 to 10 minutes. I've gone ahead and served it. It turned out excellent, friends. The chicken was very nice and soft. It was nice and juicy inside it. And the momo wrapper was nice and chewy. So give this recipe a try and post your comments. If you enjoyed watching this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me for more recipes. All the links to my blog and social media will be in the description box below this video. Until next time, this is Vidya Lakshmi. Thank you so much for watching, friends. Bye-bye.